centuries, Scargill sat on the tip of the North Riding of Yorkshire before boundary changes moved it into the county of Durham. And it's probably that one boring piece of central government legislation that saved this gatehouse. Niall Hammond and his wife-to-be first heard of it.
We can't be calling you two enthusiastic amateurs, can we?
Well, no, not really. I've been working in archaeology a good number of years, and at the time we came here, I was the county archaeologist for Durham.
It would be impertinent to ask you how much it costs, so how much did it cost?
It was a bargain at any price.
Is that what we're going to get out of it?
Exactly, yes. Yeah.
Look, this is the state of it when it was bought as a wedding present. How did you feel about it?
I was thrilled to pieces to get it, but it was also tinged with quite a bit of panic because it looked like it was going to fall down, and I was frotted by kilsang during the accident.
What was it, apart from that, that attracted you to it?
Because as an archaeologist, you live archaeology, you breathe archaeology, here is an opportunity to learn something that is a shattering one. And the more we explored it, the more we restored it, the more questions we had about it.
Standing walls scattered around us. We think we've got the remains of a tower, but we need some, some good hard dating evidence. When does the castle start? 12th century? What happens when it goes out of use in 16th, 17th century?
But we're not just looking for the 12th century origins of this gatehouse.